So we got Caicedo and Rizzo, a couple of CDMs that have finished their next development trait, which then therefore means we need to potentially switch it up, but I don't think we do. We're going to have Caicedo there. Not that greatest potential on Caicedo, and we're not even going to bother with Rizzo. He's 34 years old. Hoping Caicedo would have a bit better development, but it is what it is. We got Brentford here, so let's take a look at the standings, because we haven't taken a look at the standings in a while. So we're sitting here in third, 6 wins on the year, a couple of losses. The Manchester team's ahead of us right now. Brentford is chilling in 16th, and take a look at Bournemouth for the third straight year. There it is, chilling at 17th. They finished 17th the first 2 years. That's exactly where they are this year. West Ham down there. Southampton's actually surprising because they were really bad, and now they're 10th. So let's do this. We are at the G-Tech. It is nowhere near the same team. They got Pinnock, they got Diallo, they got Wissa. All these other guys are a lot of guys that aren't currently on their team. We are not going to wear the YouTube kits. Versus white and red. Let's go ahead and get Granelli to start here. We're just going to keep swapping it just to kind of always leave the opponent on, you know, kind of just leave them where they don't know. And then let's throw Rizzo in here for Caicedo. Give Caicedo the day off. We're playing a lot of games now. Of course, care about Cup. FA Cup coming up. And then the Champions League. Not to mention 38 games in the Premier League. So, seems like there's something going on every day here in ASMRFC land. But, hey, that's what happens when we get in European competition. We didn't have to worry about it in the first year, but now we do have to worry about it. There's a lot of tension here. He's gonna lift one up. Wow. It's raining here in London. Zlatan Jr. is almost up to an 80 now. We're gonna be a pretty good team. I mean, this is probably gonna be the last year that we don't win the championship, because after this year, we'll have all the development in these players that we've been invested in for the last couple of years. We'll have more money to fill in those empty spots. And it'll just be, we probably won't ever not win the championship again. And we'll be looking to win Champions Leagues and stuff. And the Premier League would just kind of be a secondary thing. Kind of like the PSG model in the French league, or, you know, Real Madrid, and, well, I guess that's not a good one, but like Bayern, how they just win every year, and, you know, they're really just mostly focused on the European competitions at this point. I don't know what Wissa was trying to do there, whoever that was. There's Alan Varela. He's got Modric up the middle. What a pass from the CDM. Goal. That was just beautiful team play. Alan Varela, the CDM from Boca Juniors. He ran on the outside. Hit a perfect ball to Mikhail Mudrik, who Shoots it outside the penalty area. Top corner. Oh, we got... Oh, what a ball by Mudrick, man. Across the field, back to Mudrick. Oh, no. Romero. What did he say? Okay, we get it back with Rizzo. It's Varela again. It's Varela again. Robinson. No good. And I think they should get a yellow for what they did. They're not even... No, they're not going to get a yellow. To Granelli. Oh, come on, that's a foul. Andy Robinson on the run. Look at this guy, man. Man, he took that contract they got for free agency and just played the best he's ever played. I've never seen a 69 overall play so good. Halftime, we are up at the G-Tech. Outpossessing them by quite a bit, outshooting them, winning them in the XG. They've got a lot more tackles than us. They've got more saves than them. Mudrick almost scored off that Ruben Sanchez pass. I tell you what, the passing has been great today. Everybody's in motion. They're hitting the right players. It was like he got the ball and Mudrick at the same time. That's interesting. Oh. deflected. Kicks it right to Modric. Now. Rizzo. Oh, man. All right, let's get some subs. Let's bring Caicedo in for Rizzo. Let's bring Correa in for Romero. I don't want to change too much because I like how I'm playing right now, but if we can see. Just get a couple of extra guys on the field that might change how our luck is in the final third here. Oh. That was bad. Good play by Granelli. Here's Ruben. Too much going on there. Uh-oh. Get there, Silva. Good. Nice. Nice work. The boys deserve a clean sheet if we get it. Look at Anthony. Oh. It almost worked. Interception, Ruben. Uh-oh. Granelli, you're the last one. Nice. That has not happened in a while. It was the goal by Modric from Alan Varela, which was the difference in this game. We played great defensively, played great in the midfield. The passing was real good the entire game. So I cannot complain at all.
Have you got time for just a few questions?
Sometimes you just gotta take the 1-0 win. These questions are wrong. They just said that we're undefeated since the start of the season. We're not. We have two losses.
That'll be all. Thank you so much.
So we are. This is really that game, so we need to leave this game with the draw. let's just take a look at who we could potentially be playing. So we could be playing Villarreal, Bayern Munich, Borussia Dortmund, Marseille. We can't play City because they're in our league. Roma or Sporting. So obviously pretty good teams in the round of 16 we could be getting. But I mean, when are you not going to get a good team in the round of 16 unless something crazy happens, right? So I'm not going to worry about the press conference. Alright, so we had White House. The guys say don't come off the bench the last game, so we're going to roll them on to start. If we lose this game, there's a pretty good chance that we won't win the groups. So far, obviously, we're hoping this isn't the biggest game of the year so far, but at the current moment, it is. I'm not gonna say they were easy last time, but Celtic were a harder team to play against, which is why we had that 0-0. And if we lose today, that means we need to beat Brugge. Because we'll be down by two and then have Barcelona either draw. That's all they need to do because we'll have goal differential because of what we did to Celtic. We definitely got to get a draw in this game to feel okay. Zlatan Jr. Right home, I mean, we obviously beat them at the Camp Nou. Moise ties it up. Let's go. Way to be persistent. Are back in the lead. I said, tried to get foremost. Alright, it's halftime. Let's go. They might have something here. To Barcelona. I mean, what a game it's been, but a bit of an unfortunate end. I think we could still tie it. Oh, it wasn't letting me turn around. Rigged. It's rigged. Oh, it's rigged. Oh my, they didn't let me turn around. You saw that. That guy just like ran.